Hello to you. Now, a state of emergency has been in place for half a century in Syria. How willing are the authorities there to actually lift it now?
Well, I think we should expect that the authorities in Syria are going to try to establish what the minimum is that they have to do to reverse the trend of demonstrations in the street. But we've seen that in other places before. Yes, Syria is unique. It's not exactly the same as Egypt or Tunisia, but too little too late actually seems to fuel the momentum of the demonstrators who feel insulted by the idea that you just have to tell them there, go away, we'll look after it, we'll make some changes, but we know what's best. They react badly to that.
But there is a presidential dynasty, isn't there, in Syria, with the current president succeeding his own father. So what's your assessment of how far he'll go to cling to power in the existing power structure?
Well, he's shown quite a lot of tenacity so far. He had to establish himself after his father. He was not the son who was groomed for power. His older brother was, but his older brother was killed in a car accident. Most people don't think there was anything mysterious about that. But anyway, Bashar al-Assad then found himself inheriting his father's mantle, and he had to mediate between competitors from the old guard that used to surround his father. He survived all of that. He's also shown tenacity in terms of surviving the criticism, which was intense against him in connection with the assassination of former Prime Minister Hariri of Lebanon, which resulted in Syria having to pull its troops out of Lebanon, and looked like Bashar al-Assad would have to deliver some of his key henchmen, including one of his brothers, to an international tribunal for trial in connection with that assassination. But he seems to have ridden out that danger too, pretty much. So this is a man with tenacity and adaptability.
And he and the government both claim foreign forces are backing the protesters. Do you think that's likely?
Now, exactly where the configuration is inside Syria is difficult to tell, because on the one hand, in terms of the state apparatus, you have the Ba'ath Party, and that is almost such a part of the system that you can't tell whether people belong to it in order to get on within the system or because they actually believe in its principles. But it is a power structure that is down to the grassroots. And obviously there are people in that power structure who have vested interests, and whether they could change the leadership or contemplate change of the leadership if it also meant lock, stock and barrel change of the party structure is one question. And then you have the security services, of which there are several, with overlapping remits, deliberately set up in competition with each other to prevent any one of them becoming too powerful. So the situation militates against popular mobilization en bloc against the leadership.
Okay, Professor Rosemary Hollis of Middle East Policy Studies at City University in London, many thanks for those thoughts.